This week, Parliament approved amendments in the Income Tax Act and imposed a tax on companies reporting losses for more than 7 years, with 50% of the losses carried forward now being subject to tax in new amendments to the law. MPs created a middle ground of 7 years, abandoning the government's earlier suggestion to tax losses carried forward in 5 years.
Locating carried forward losses to taxpayers indefinitely incentivizes them to overclaim losses and hence enabling them to remain in an artificial loss-making position.
Let us take an example. If you say this should be recovered in 5 years, it means you would take 10 divided by 5. It gives you 2 billion. Which business in Uganda will make profit of 2 billion a year?
In the same Income Tax Amendment Bill 2023, the House approved 5% tax on digital companies owned by foreigners, which operate in Uganda, like Facebook, Twitter, Amazon, Netflix, among others. In this new tax measure, the government projects to collect at least 5 billion shillings in the first financial year, which will increase in the future.
Taxing income derived by non-resident providers of digital services in Uganda be maintained.
The chairman of the committee said in his report that Uber service, the money goes to California, and this beneficiary leaves no tax in Uganda. He derives income by providing Uber services, and you repay online, the money will go to California.
In amending the same bill, Parliament finally considered and approved 1 year extension of corporate income tax waiver for Bujagali Energy Limited, awaiting audit and renegotiation of the contract as directed by Parliament. In granting this waiver, the government is to forego 96 billion shillings revenue.
It is necessary to grant a 1 year extension to Bujagali Energy Limited in order to protect the end user from high tariff.
Honourable members, I put a question that the Income Tax Amendment Bill 2023, as returned by His Excellency the President, be read a third time and do pass. Those in favour say and the contrary nay.
Away from legislation, Parliament this week directed the government to find funds to cover funding shortfalls of the Higher Students Financing Board to ensure that enrolled students complete their studies at different institutions. This followed a recommendation by COSASE, which scrutinized the entity and highlighted funding gaps and regional imbalances.
The committee observes that 1. There is a lack of regional balance among the beneficiaries of the loan scheme. The committee found that whereas the loan scheme was meant to aid students from underprivileged backgrounds, the vast majority of the beneficiaries of the scheme, according to the information from the board, were from districts which were not as underprivileged.
Let's cover all students who go for either arts or sciences.
I'm disturbed by the process whereby only science students are catered for.
Still this week, Parliament went hard on the government to prioritize funding of the elections for Local Council 1, 2 and the Women Councils. This was after the current tenure of local council leaders expired on Monday, leaving a big vacuum in village leadership.
Madam Speaker, yesterday we had people who failed to buy land in Busia Sofia because the chairman feared to sign because his term have expired. This is a very important matter that I think the minister should not come with lamentations. You should come with an authority so that the local councils can continue working, and as a government we should stop working with the crisis.
The issue of money pertaining to the elections of the LC1s and LC2s that their term, and the women council that their term has expired.
The Speaker of Parliament, Anita Among, has called for a strategic crisis meeting with senior government officials to find solutions to the increasing road accidents, and they resolve that Uganda National Roads Authority provide 8 standby vehicles to tow stationary cars which break down on the roads.
The Road Act of 2019, which addresses the various aspects of the road safety, does not have regulations.
The Public Accounts Committee of Parliament this week discovered that the government is yet to settle 634 million shillings for burial expenses of the Emoremore Augustine Osban Lemukol, the Itaso culture leader who was granted a state funeral in February 2022.
Fortunate to learn that of that commitment of 710 million shillings, service providers to date are still demanding.
When we submitted the bill to finance in the subsequent month, they kept telling us they would give us the money. When we got to the close of the financial year, we still didn't have the money.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.